Glad to see you.
What seems to be the matter, Doki?
Oh, well, I need you guys to stay calm. Captain Barbaros was attacked. He's hurt pretty bad.
Oh, was it a beast?
Actually, we think a person did this.
Person? Are you sure? Why would anyone do such a thing?
Dr. Kiergaard says his injuries aren't life-threatening. Come with me to the lodge. I'll give you the details there.
Oh, Adol. Something terrible has happened.
Thank you for coming, Adol. Sorry I'm not decent at the moment.
Nemo is a Roman word. It means nameless.
Thank you.
In Barbarossa's leg.
Then, what if that nameless ripper's still lurking nearby?
We must tend to Sir Carlin's wound before we do anything else. Come with me, Mr. Kristen. We'll get him some help.
Happening?
More beasts?
Well, whatever it was, it sounded very close.
Do you think it might be?
I'm sure of it. You think it might be the monster that attacks Sahad?
Go!
Yes.
Fine. Tell me anything. Roger, give me a second. All finished. All right, then. Thank you.
Let's see. This is great. This is from me.
Can I help you?
Take care.
What do you want to enhance? Tell me anything.
Let's go, everyone!
Yeah!
My turn now!
Yeah.
On guard!
All right, let's push through! Looks like they're here!
Struggling! Doki Squad struggling!
one just a little longer.
He's putting us through the ringer.
This way.
What is that? What are they doing? Did we just get saved?
It seems we have.
Thank you.
think? That creature is almost certainly a primordial.
A primordial? Didn't we find some note at the watchtower that mentioned them?
Long ago, before the human race came into existence, enormous creatures of unimaginable power ruled the Earth before going extinct. These creatures are known as primordials. Though diverse in form, their defining traits are their reptilian appearance and ferocious disposition.
You bated our breaths for this nonsense? What makes you qualified to judge that creature as a product of some bygone era?
I've heard of these primordials too. According to reports, fossils of these giant creatures have been found deep underground. Certain academic circles within the Roman Empire have recently begun more research into the matter.
Are you some kind of expert on these primordial beasts, Laxia?
Yes. I won't bore you with the details, but I'm well versed on the subject.
Finally, some good news!
Huh?
Since you know about them, you can help us figure out how to fight them off! Ain't that right, little lady?
I don't know how much help I can truly provide at this time.
The less we know about these creatures, the more we will fear them with each passing day. It would do wonders for morale to know we have someone who understands what we're up against.
I hardly think I'm...
Don't be so modest, right, Adol?
Very well, then.
Damn. First a serial killer, now primordials? That's too many things we gotta worry about right now.
Don't come off it, will you? I'm too terrified by the nameless Ripper hiding in our midst to pay any mind to these so-called primordials. I wish I was anywhere else but this accursed island. I grow sicker and wearier each day I'm forced to breathe the same air as you riffraff.
Jeez, what a pain in the ass that guy is.
This is quite difficult to climb, actually. Thank you, Mr. Kristen. That was my first time climbing a rope ladder. I didn't think it would sway so much.
What's wrong?
Well, today was rather eventful. And I'm not as lackadaisical as Sahad, so unlike him, I'm having a difficult time falling asleep tonight. And I suppose I couldn't think of anything else to do at this hour, so here.
Is that...
Yes, and you better thank me for it. I've never prepared this dish before, so I can't vouch for its flavor. Really? I thought the end result would look more appetizing than this. By the way, have you spoken to Hummel at all? I asked him where he went, but he said it would be unprofessional of him to tell me. What's his aim? Take a while, but I suppose you're not going anywhere for the time being. My father taught me all about the primordials. He was an archaeological scholar, you see, who specialized in the study of primordials. As a child, I often visited his laboratory, and he would have me accompany him on his excavations. I loved and respected my father. He was my whole world. But the year I turned 16, my father grew so obsessed with his research that he abandoned his house and lands. In response, his people began rioting throughout the countryside. The rioting finally ceased when my brother assumed control of House Roswell. But the loyalty our house once commanded had already been lost. Soon after, the other noble houses successfully unseated my brother, which drove my mother ill. And just 3 months ago, House Roswell was forced to relinquish its titles and lands, and now, my family's future has never been more uncertain. My father taught me many things, but after everything that happened, I began to grow dissatisfied with all that had come to define me, and I felt as if I had no place where I truly belonged. So I ran away from home. I hesitated earlier today because I never imagined my knowledge could actually prove useful, though this is hardly the time to feel this way. I think I finally found somewhere I belong. Not settle for just that. I think I'm the one who understands my father best, so I've made up my mind. If I manage to escape this place, I will search for my father. Only then will I find where I truly belong.
Yes.
I hope so, but he did travel rather extensively. A noble. He was a rather carefree and welcoming man. That is to say, as an adventurer, you remind me of him. You even resemble him somewhat. Which may be why my behavior has been so, unseemly. So, I'm sorry. Please, you don't need to be so kind. I was forcing you to bear the brunt of my resentment toward my father. Thank you for letting me confide in you. Good night, Adol.
get him. We gotta hurry. Jump to him.
To spend another second on that island, living among common riffraff. It falls upon me to ferry myself to freedom, to escape this infernal place once and for all.
Good thing he got stuck. Ahoy!
Sir Carlin, please! You must return to shore!
No good. Doesn't look like he can hear us. Huh? Oh, no. Hey, Adol, you seeing what I'm seeing?
What? What is the meaning of this? Shoo! Shoo, I say! Away with you!
That's the tentacle what sunk the Lombardia. Sure as there's salt in the sea.
So that's what the captain was talking about.
We can't just stand here gawping. We gotta help that stuffed shirt, Adol. No.
Why have these creatures come to impede us? Here they come! Giant cephalopods, but that's neither here nor there.
It retreated. Where'd that stuffed shirt Carlin float off to?
Thank you. Thank you.
did he go?
Thought I saw him heading downstream, along the river, this way.
Are you sure? No one is here.
Wait! Stop!
Huh? What was that?
You okay?
Something just nicked my neck. What happened?
Over there, Adol! There's something near that tree!
Thank you. some. It's done. It's done.
Oh, hello, Adol. Something the matter? Why so serious? Has someone else been hurt?
Nice weather we're having today, Dr. Kiergard. Thank God for that, huh? Now, I don't have to try to apprehend you in the rain.
oh dear, Officer Euron. You never got the chance to rendezvous with your partner on the ship, did you?
I knew it. You're the bastard who killed him, Kiergard. Or should I say, the Nameless Ripper.
So it was you, Doctor. But why?
Bravo! Simply...
beautiful.
When this began, you castaways were perfect strangers to one another.
But look at you now.
Look how your bond and trust has flourished! All for the sake of survival! There is no better way to describe it.
The hell are you talking about?
Consider, if you will, an opposing perspective. Had we not washed ashore, had I not made myself a threat, that beauty would have died in vain.
That's absurd!
Don't listen to this lunatic. He's a serial killer.
Come quietly, Dr. Kiergard. This is a deserted island. There is nowhere for you to run.
Such as I to exist? Your unjust treatment is the real cruelty!
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yourself at all.
We finally caught up.
Where's that nameless son of a bitch?
We haven't found him yet. I believe Caro is still looking for him.
Looks like he came back!
Found girl! Found girl!
A girl?
What's he talking about?
Huh? Look. Fast or she'll be beast chow.
Can't afford to lose any more survivors.
Captain!
My leg! This must be one of Nameless's traps. Please be on your guard.
You think he's nearby?
Knew I made the right choice capturing that lost little urchin.
Use that kid as bait.
Underhanded cur! How dare he!
We gotta treat the captain's wound!
I wouldn't waste your time! I'm all but certain his femoral artery has been sliced clean through. Even if you treat his wound right away, his odds of survival are grim at best.
No.
Adol, please. Dr. Kiergard. No. Nameless. Capture him.
Captain?
Drowsiness is a well-known symptom of exsanguination. That makes two victims now! If you bother to count, Sir Carlin, of course. And now I shall take my leave.
Get back here!
I knew you'd be the one to pursue me, Adol. I could see it in your clear eyes, the passion burning deep inside you. And when I first met you, I could tell at that exact moment, you are a worthy target.
You have your sights set on Adol now?
I didn't expect the other castaways to survive long on this island. I thought they would fall prey to beasts once despair set in, or they would fight amongst themselves after all semblance of order had broken down. I was wrong. You, the captain, and the village have given them hope. Everyone has begun to work toward the common goal of escaping this island. It's just so beautiful! It would be so tragic if something terrible were to happen to you or the captain. Why, the mere thought sends a quiver down my spine.
That's why you attacked the captain? And why you're going after Adol?
Not just them. That stuffed shirt Carlin, and that little girl, too. You've done terrible things no man should ever do, Doctor.
Who are you to tell me what I should and should not do? As one who bears the burden of evil, I took the only normal course of action. Yes. I am the counterpart to a paragon of righteousness such as yourself, Adol. People can only advance when they have land to tread on. Progress cannot be made without two diametrically opposing forces, good and evil. With these concepts, we give meaning to society and history. Do you think the world as you know it would still exist without evil? And yet, the existence of evil is seen as a blight to be purged without hesitation. Does that not seem irrational to you?
Never thought I'd meet anyone who was rotten to their core.
Never expected this conversation to result in mutual understanding between us. After all, a conflict between good and evil is inevitable.
Go!
Guess we're fighting our way out of this one.
We cannot afford to lose you, Adol. Let's face him together!
History only concerns itself with the results. Therefore, in the name of evil, I will rip my way into the pages of history. Come! The doctor will see you now! All right, let's begin!
Still go!
You're more resilient than I expected.
I didn't think a mere adventurer, was it?
Would pose such a challenge.
But this island is the perfect breeding ground for evil. I've no intention of letting things end here.
No, he's gonna get away. Whoa!
Wire trap. We cannot blindly rush him.
Damn! How prepped is this guy?
Next time will be much more fun. Now then.
What? The primordial?
That was unexpected.
Yes, things certainly took a turn just now. We must hurry back to the captain right away. Let's go, Adol.
That's right. We gotta hurry.
You're back.
Adol, it would seem your battle with Nameless is over.
How's the captain doing?
Well...
it's just as Nameless said. The wound is indeed fatal. I'm sorry.
No! There must be something we can do!
I'm sorry, Laxia. I know I told everyone that we'd make it off this island alive.
Don't say that.
Hang in there, Captain. You promised we'd all see our families again. Think of your daughter.
I'm sorry, Salad. I guess I can't keep that promise.
This just ain't right.
Adol, I'm sorry, but I need you to do something for me. One last promise. Please, you must get everyone off this island. Alive. I know you can do it, Adol.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you. Their fate is in your hands now.
That is the schedule for today. Your Eminence, are you tired from all the ceremonies you've attended these past few days?
Yes, a little.
We will be departing for the Great Valley, where the Arboreal Awakening will be held. We still have some time before we depart. Perhaps you would like to get some rest?
Yes, I would very much like that. Thank you kindly. You should get some rest too. I think it would do us both good.
I certainly shall. When you are ready to leave, please come let me know.
I will. Thank you. There go. All this formality's wearing me out. I should go walk around first.
Yeah. maiden of the great tree.
Almost time. I have to depart. I don't see Olga or Sarai nearby. I'm sure I'll see them again. Sarai! What are you doing here? Your Eminence, we are honored to bear witness as you perform the Arboreal Awakening.
Thank you for allowing us to be part of this.
Stop it, you guys. This is gonna be weird now.
With all due respect, Your Eminence, you have already submitted yourself to the Great Tree of Origins. Please strive to conduct yourself in a more dignified manner as befits your station. Royalty and their subjects will all be in attendance to witness the proceedings.
Yes, I will.
Your Eminence must journey to the hallowed ground of the Great Valley. In accordance with the ancient precepts, you shouldn't encounter any danger as you undergo this trial. But please, do not overexert yourself. If you need anything, we will not be far.
I understand. Thank you.
Once you set foot on that hallowed ground, you will submit yourself to the Arboreal Awakening. But first, you must make your way to the depths of the Great Valley.
Now, Your Eminence, please conduct the opening ceremony of the Arboreal Awakening.
Okay. I am Donna. I have answered the call of the Great Tree of Origins and offered myself to become its appointed maiden. I stand ready to undergo my trial, so that Eternia may receive blessings everlasting. O Great Tree, O maidens past, please, let your strength wash over me. Let the Arboreal Awakening commence!
Well done, Your Eminence.
Please, make your way to the end of the path. The trial begins now.
Thank you.
At last, Donna will witness the future of Eternia.
Yes.
Donna, what's wrong? Are you all right?
I can't breathe.
Donna, are you okay?
Yes, I just felt like I was drowning. I think I got too nervous, that's all.
Are you? Never mind. As long as you're sure you're okay, that's all that matters. Your Eminence, have you safely completed the awakening?
Yes, it went fine. I saw a vision of a calm, beautiful ocean.
How wonderful! A calm ocean is a symbol of peace and prosperity. Surely Eternia will know peace in your time.
Yes. What was that vision? And why was it?